Okay, firstly, in our control circuit, we have the TF494 IC, which will be used to produce a 3-volt peak sawtooth waveform. Now, we're going to use this trimmer located here, along with this capacitor, to produce this 3-volt peak sawtooth waveform. Nextly, we have the LF356 op amp in a non-inverting configuration, in combination with this trimmer located next to it, to produce a 10-volt peak sawtooth waveform. Nextly, we have the LM311, which will use the control voltage from this trimmer and compare it with our 10-volt peak sawtooth waveform in order to produce a PWM signal of a certain duty ratio. The PWM signal then goes into the CD4050 located here, which is used in combination with the MIC4424 located here to increase our drive current. Finally, we have our isolated driving circuit, a pulse transformer in combination with some passive components, which is used to provide some isolation between our control circuit and our converter.
Flyback Converter 的实作电路图，我们这边借由输入 110AC 经过乔氏整流变成 156DC， 啊，这边是我们的 RCD snubber， 啊，这边是我们的 RC snubber， 这边是我们的变压器，这边是 N1:N2 是 7:1， 哦，这边是我们开关，借由驱动讯号、驱动电路传送驱动讯号给开关的 GS 角，这边是我们的输出是 12伏。 啊，我们满载是24瓦，然后 12瓦 以上的时候 CCM， 啊，这边是我们这一条是我们的 测量 IDS， 这边是 ID。
Here we have our probes placed for the measurement of Vin, Vout, and VGS. We're expecting 156 volts DC on the input here. And we're expecting a 12-volt output over here. Firstly, we could see our VGS waveform right here. Next, we have our input of 156 volts, as we can see by the measurement number 4 right here. And last but not least, we have our 12-volt output right here. Here we have our probes configured for the measurement of the voltage across the gate and the source of the MOSFET, as well as the drain and the source of our MOSFET. Here we can see the VGS waveform as previously seen, as well as our VDS waveform. The spike expected as well as the ringing across the waveform have both been dealt with using our RCD and RC snubbers. This is what VDS would look like without the addition of the RCD and RC snubbers. Here we can see the high ringing frequency. Here we have our circuit configured for the measurement of IDS. Since we are unable to measure the theoretical magnetization inductance, we will use IDS as an indication as to whether we are in CCM or not. As seen right here, since the initial current during the on state is not zero, we are indeed in CCM. We can see again that our initial value in the on state is non-zero, meaning that again, at 12 watts, we are still in CCM. As can be seen above, we are starting with an initial current of 0 amps, which means that we are operating in DCM when we operate with an output load of 11 watts. The green plot is the output current and the purple is the output voltage. You can see at this point in time, The current goes from high to low, indicating that we're moving from a high load here to a low load down here. We can see up here that there's a very slight variation, a slight increase in the output voltage as we move from a heavy load to a light load. We can see in the reverse situation, moving from a light load to a heavy load, as the current increases at this point in time, there is a slight drop in the output voltage as seen here. In order to allow for a constant output through disturbances such as changes to the input voltage, as well as changes in the output requirements, a type 3 compensator circuit needs to be designed and incorporated into the driving circuit. Firstly, the GS transfer function needed to be ascertained. In order to accomplish this in the most efficient manner possible, a custom MATLAB script was written, which was used to automatically estimate GS given frequency response data from the lab's frequency analyzer. With a phase margin of 50 degrees, the required controller features a crossover magnitude of 17 dB, a crossover phase of 1.5 degrees, a median zero frequency of 1600 Hz, and a median pole frequency of 9800 Hz. As can be seen, the open loop transfer function is stable, and the expected phase at crossover is minus 130 degrees. Here, our controller, plant, and open loop transfer functions are simultaneously plotted for reference. With the type 3 compensator included, it can be seen that as we move from a light load to a heavy load, there is a short transient before the output voltage returns to 12 volts. There is, however, an excessive ripple which needs to be dealt with. In the reverse case, as we move from a heavy load to a light load, there is another short transient before the output voltage returns to 12 volts. There is a reduced ripple which may or may not be proportional to the output current.